Hello iPad letterers, welcome back to my channel. My name is Karen, I'm from iPad Lettering and I'm here to help you explore all the wonderful things you can create with your iPad. In today's video, I want to show you how you can install a custom font onto your iPad. Some of the apps you might have on your iPad, such as Procreate or maybe Affinity Designer, they let you install fonts as part of the app. But the problem is if you have an app that won't let you install custom fonts, then those fonts won't be available. So now I'm going to show you how you can install a font on your iPad so that it will be available for any app on the iPad. Unfortunately, this functionality is not available out of the box with iPad OS. So that means we need to install a custom app first. So let's go to the App Store and let's see what options we have. I'm going to bring up the App Store. One of the apps I really like is called iFont. So let's search that. And then you'll see that there is another app called AnyFont that comes up as well. And I've actually got both of these apps installed on my iPad already and I've tried them both. AnyFont is an app that I've been using for quite a while, but iFont is a new app that I've just discovered and I actually much prefer iFont. Also because it's got a free version, AnyFont is not free. I think when I got this a few years ago, it was 99 cents, so it's not expensive, but iFont is an app you can use for free and we like free, right? So let's go for that. So let's open up the app and then the first thing you see here is the installer section. You've also got some more tabs here at the bottom. And the first one that we are going to check out is the font finder. There are several different ways of how you can install fonts onto your iPad. And one of the interesting options, for example, that's not available in any font is that you can choose Google fonts. But what I actually recommend rather than scrolling through here and finding a font that you like is that you go to Safari and you bring up fonts.google.com because it has additional categories and it's also got font properties that you can use to filter your fonts, which makes it a lot easier to find the font that you want. And then once you've found the font that you would like to install, you want to go back to iFont and then you can just search it here. And for example, one of the fonts that I really like is called Montserrat and it's this one here. And then once you've found the font, all you have to do is tap on get and then it'll become available in your installer here. So you can see here, we've got all these fonts available. But then another option you have is actually use your own font files. So if you tap on this, you can now load a font that you have on your iPad already. So if you downloaded the font, if you've purchased the font, make sure you save it to your iCloud Drive or Dropbox. This one's actually in Dropbox so that you have the file available. The file you can see here is a font that I made myself and you can get this font if you'd like to have it. It's free on my website. I'll link it down below in the description box, but I just want to show you real quick what this looks like. This font is called Casarina and it's a neat quirky font I made for myself for my journals. Or you can see it float around my website for a few covers and things as well. So you can have this font for free for any personal project. If you use it for commercial purposes, please get the extended version, which is available on my website as well. All right, so now let's install this font as well. Let's go to iFont and then you want to grab that OTF file. So you tap on that and then you can see here, installer says we have it available for installation. So now one of the things that's really nice with this app as well is that you can now decide to install all of these fonts at once. With any font, you would have to individually install all of these fonts, but with iFont, you can do them all at once. But having said that, with the Casarina font, we actually want to install this separately. And the way it works is that this app downloads a configuration profile that will get loaded into your settings app. So you're going to have to allow this first. And now the profile is downloaded. So now we can close this dialog and also close this box. And now we have to go to our settings app. And then you'll see here that profile downloaded now is available. So we tap on this and now it asks us to install this profile. And the reason why we have to do this is a security feature of iPadOS to make sure that you don't accidentally install malicious files onto your iPad so that you're very aware that you're actually installing this file. And I really recommend that you only install fonts from reputable sources so that you're not accidentally installing any malware onto your iPad. All right, so now tap install and then you have to enter your passcode. Again, this is to make sure that you are aware that you're doing this. And then again, there is another warning that this profile is not signed. This means this is a file that didn't come through the App Store and therefore hasn't been signed, but that's fine. We're going to go install and install the profile. And now it's done and the font is now available for any app of the iPad. Now let's go back and I want to show you now what's so good about using iFont. So now we've installed this font already, but now if we want to install more than one font at the same time, what we can do now is tap select. And now we can select all the fonts that we want to install at the same time. So now I usually don't like the italic font weights, so I'm going to unselect them. And I really recommend that you don't install all the font weights. And this is simply to improve the performance of the application, just to make sure that not too many files have to be loaded into the app every time the app starts up. All right, so now these are the fonts that I want, and then tap install. So now the same thing happens. You can give it a custom name. Before we only had one font weight, but now it's got this list of fonts to install. And so what I recommend is to actually rename it and just call it whatever that font name is, like this, and then tap install. And now this is exactly the same process. We tap allow, install, done. And then we're going to go back to our settings, and you can see here we've got profile again, and this is the name we gave it. And then you can also see now this includes 10 fonts. So now we're going to go install. And now we are finished. And that's how easy it was. So now let's have a look in Procreate. Let's bring up Procreate and let's see if these fonts are actually available. I very much recommend that you restart any app that you might have open before you are using the font, just to make sure that they're getting loaded. So now we have a piece of text here, and let's edit style. And let's now choose our Caserina font. And there it is. And now let's bring up Zinnia as well to do the same thing. And let's change the font here. So again, let's have a look through our list of fonts. And here is the Caserina font. And that's how easy it is. Now, just to recap the process, all you have to do is go to the App Store, find a suitable app that lets you install custom fonts onto the iPad. I recommend either AnyFont or iFont. And out of the two, I really like using the iFont app. Then the next thing is to find fonts to install. You can either use Google Fonts. I very much recommend using Google Fonts because they are available for both personal and commercial projects. Or of course, you can use your own fonts as well. Make sure you have a look on my website where you can find that free Caserina font. I've got another couple of fonts that I made as well. And then all you have to do is download that custom profile and then go to your settings app and install that profile from there. And then one last tip, really make sure that you restart all your apps before you start using your custom font, just to make sure that it's all loaded properly and that it's available and ready to go. I really hope you found this video useful. Give me a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and share this video with your friends and family or anyone that you can think of that would like to know how to install custom fonts onto their iPad. I'm also going to loop up another couple of videos here so that you can see some of the apps where you can use your custom fonts. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.